My name is Ori Mosambane Malonga. I am from Equatorial Guinea, a small country in the center of Africa. I get into swimming, I think when I finished my high school. In my country, we didn't have swimming pool. We didn't have anything. So I was training in a private swimming pool. It was in an hotel building. The swimming pool was for, I think, 13 meters. So I used to train there by myself. I didn't have any experience about swimming. I was just, just watching, I didn't know anything. The swimming pool was gonna be available for me from 5 o'clock in the morning until 6 o'clock. It was just 3 hours a week for me to use the hotel. But beside that, I was also training in the river and in the beach with some fishermen that was teaching me how to move my legs, how to swim, how to that. Not professional swimming, just to be, not to be sinking. At that time, I haven't heard about Sydney, I haven't heard about Australia. That was my first time to travel to that continent, you know, because it was, we took from my country to Australia, we took 3 days traveling by doing some certain stops in certain countries. So when I arrived in Australia, it was just amazing, you know, because the place, the country was big, amazing people, and people in the airport, people embrace us, people wait for us there. When I saw everything in the Olympic Village, because the Olympic Village was so big, very big, you know. And also I remember when I saw the swimming pool for the first time, you know, that was my first time to swim a 50-meter swimming pool. So I was so scared because they told me that that is going to be the swimming pool that I was going to compete. So I told my people that it's going to be very difficult for me because the swimming pool was so big for me. Because I didn't have so resistance to compete in that way. My training schedule was the same time with the United States swimmers. So I used to go there and see how they train, because I didn't have any techniques, anything. I was just watching how they do, how they swim. I was just sitting, watching how they train. So at that time, I had a little experience for how to dive, how to start everything, because I didn't have any experience. By myself, I had to start asking people how to do and how to have information. Some people were ignoring me, and others were just helping me, because when they saw me swimming in the training area, some come and asked me if I am a swimmer, if I'm going to compete. I told him that yes, I was going to compete, and he told me that he doesn't see a swimmer in me. I mean that because he felt I don't have any technique and I don't know how to do things. He was going to teach me, and he was the South African coach. He told me how to move my leg, how to move my arm, and everything. But the problem was that I didn't know how to coordinate my breathing.
Ladies and gentlemen, please welcome to the pool deck the competitors in the first of 10 heats for the men's 100 meter freestyle.
I was so nervous. I remember that in the room area to change, I was just, I was so nervous that I didn't know how to even to speak to people, you know. But I remember when they called my country, when I came out, I saw many people. I just say hi to people when they called me, and I saw many people. I was so nervous that, oh my God, I'm going to sing in front of these people. I was so scared of doing something that people was going to laugh about me.
In lane 5, representing Equatorial Guinea, Eric Musambane. This is heat 1.
I was so nervous, and something in my mind came and saying that, oh, guy, go for it, you can do it. So, but later on, when I saw that the two guys were disqualified, that make me, I was thinking that first of all, I was also disqualified because I saw them going into the pool the same time and I was just standing. When the referee say to stop, I was thinking that I was the one who has been disqualified. But later on, the referee told me that I am the one who have to swim. That gave me more nervous because I knew that everybody was watching me. Many channels was watching me. When I first dive into the water, the first 50 meters, I did it very well. I think I used all my energy because I used all my energy to swim the 50 meters. In my mind was just that, hey, go and finish and everything, because everybody was watching me. I knew my family, my country, my mother, my sister, my friends were watching me. That's why I was so hungry that I have to compete, I have to do it. Even that I'm alone in the swimming pool, I have to do it. I didn't care about the time, you know. My only preoccupation was that I have to complete the 100 meters. I started heard about the crowd for the second lap when I was going back, but at that time I was so tired because I couldn't feel my legs when I was in the middle of the swimming pool. At the time I was just moving and I was feeling that I am in the same place, not moving. But when I start hearing people crowding, people shouting, people saying, hey, go, that gave me more strength and power to finish. When I touched the finish line, it was just, oh, I did it. You know, because I was, okay, the first swimmer in my country to complete 100 international competition swimming style. I was so happy that I did it. Even with the time that it wasn't good, but I did it. I did 1 minute, 52 seconds. You know, because actually I was qualified, but they said about the time it wasn't good. But I think the spirit of the Olympic is not just a competition, it's just participation. And that strength and that spirit Olympic that you transmit to people, I think that's what makes me famous, I think, because people love that. Because when I get out of the pool, people came around me trying to give me congratulations, greet me and so on. I was so exhausted, so I went and slept. After 4 hours, I wake up and I saw the media in the Olympic Village auditorium that they was waiting for me because people was asking about me. And when I was walking around in the Olympic Village, people was just asking me about autograph, and I didn't know anything about that. So when I start seeing my image, my race, my face in the TV, all channel area, CNN and those other channels, international channels, I knew that maybe I did something that people love. So that's when people started asking about me, interview and things like that. That changed everything in my life, because when I did my 100 meters freestyle, when I get out of the pool, my name, Eric Mosambani, and my country, everybody knew about it. Right now, I'm trying to promote swimming in my country. I'm trying to help people, that the young guys that they want to start swimming, so not to be a good swimmer, because right now in my country we have a 50 meter swimming pool. So I want to encourage people to start swimming, to start doing sport, and to stop doing bad things.